Good morning, my dear students. How are you all? I hope you all are fine at your home. In the previous video, we discussed about the story of the curious baby elephant. He was such a curious fellow. He would ask questions about anything that he saw or heard or felt or smelt or touched. Then he asked the ostrich why her tail feather grew just so. Then he asked the questions to giraffe what made his skin sporty. Then he asked questions to hippo why his eyes were red. And then he asked the question to the baboon why melons tasted as they did. For that, his parents spanked him, and his uncle and aunt also spanked him when he would not stop asking question. Then one more question he want to ask, that is, what does a crocodile have for dinner? One day he want to know that, you know, that he was such a curious fellow. He want to know that what does a crocodile have for dinner. For that, he asked question to animals that what does a crocodile have for dinner, but he did not get the answer. So one day he met the Kolo Kolo bird. She told him where he could find an answer. Then he went to grey-green, greasy Limpopo River for find the answer. So when he went off, then he carried a load of bananas and sugar cane and melon on the way for eat. Then after a week of trudging and budging, he reached where he had to reach. Then at the edge of the river, he stepped on what he thought was a log of wood, but it was not. When he winked one eyes, then he said, "Excuse me, but have you seen a crocodile in this part?" asked the elephant child politely to the creature that is actually a crocodile. But elephant child did not know about him. Then the elephant child grew excited and kneeled down and asked again to the crocodile. And he said to him that, "I have been looking for you all these days," he said. Then he asked again question to the crocodile that, "Will you please tell me what you have for dinner?" Then suddenly a sound came, splat. There went the crocodile's tail back into the oozy mud. Oozy means watery mud. Then crocodile said to the baby elephant that, "Come nearer, little one, come nearer, I will whisper," said crocodile. Then elephant child put his head down close to the crocodile's musky and tusky mouth, and the crocodile caught him by his little nose. Now, my dear students, I hope you all have understood the story up to here. Now we are going to continue our story. So you can see on the screen on page number 47. "I think," said the crocodile, and he said it between his teeth like this, "I think today I will begin with you, elephant's child." The elephant's child knew he was in big trouble. He was in big trouble. He sat back on his haunches and he pulled and pulled. The crocodile splashed in the water and pulled and pulled. Both of them pulled and pulled, and the elephant's nose kept stretching and stretching. At last, the crocodile let go. Now the sign came. BF. UDD, UDD. Then feels the elephant right on his big broad back. He looked at his nose. He could not see where it end. It was long. So long. He could swish it around, but it hurt him awfully. So he wrapped the nose in cool bananas, leaves, and waited for it to shrink. Then he waited and waited, but nothing happened. He could still swish it all around. At the end of the third day, a fly came and stung him on the shoulder. And before he knew what he was doing, he lifted up his trunk and hit that fly dead with the end of it. So here is the next part. You can see. I think, said the crocodile. I think I will begin with you. He said this line to elephant's child that he wanted to eat him. That is why he said to the elephant child that I think today I will begin with you. The elephant child knew. Then suddenly elephant child get to know that he was in big trouble. Then he sat back on his haunches. Here haunches means you can see the back portion of the body of crocodile. Then and he pulled and pulled. Then he pulled and pulled. Then the crocodile splashed in the water and pulled and pulled. He want to go ahead and ahead. Then both of them pulled and pulled. Means crocodile put their side and elephant child pulled their side. And the elephant nose kept stretching and stretching because the elephant child caught by his nose. That's why elephant's nose kept stretching and stretching. At last the crocodile let go. Then the elephant felt that right on his big broad back. He looked at his nose. Then elephant felt that right on his back, broad back. He feels there. Then he looked at his nose, but he could not see where it ended. Where it ended, because elephant's nose kept stretching and stretching. And by the stretching of his nose, it was long, but become long and so long. So he could switch it around, but it hurt him awfully because his nose was hurt. That is why. Then so he wrapped the nose in cool banana leaves and waited for it to shrink. Then again he waited and waited, but nothing happened. He was waited for his nose to shrink, but nothing happened. He could still swish it all around. At the end of the third day, a fly came and stung him on the shoulder. And before he knew what he was doing, he lifted up his trunk and hit that fly and with the end of it. Now he said to himself, this seems to be useful thing. When he felt that the fly dead, then he said to himself, this seems to be a useful thing. He felt better now and hungry too. Then he put out his long nose and plucked a large bundle of grass, then dusted it clean against his forelegs and stuffed it into his mouth. He found that he could easily pluck the fruit of the tree instead of waiting for it to fall. He was happy that his new nose was turning out to be quite useful. He went back to his family and had a jolly time spanking his brothers and sisters with his new trunk. When the other elephants could bear it no longer, they all went to the crocodile to get new noses, just like this. So thanks to the very curious elephant child, all the elephants today have long trunk. So my dear students, listen here once again carefully. How he realized, how the curious baby elephant realized that how his new nose was quite useful. When he felt better and hungry, then he put out his long nose and plucked a large bundle of grass. Then he dusted it clean against his forelegs and stuffed it into his mouth. Then he found that he could easily pluck the fruit of the tree instead of waiting for it to fall from the tree. That is why he was happy that his new nose was turning out to be quite useful. He can use his nose. Then he went back to his family and had a jolly time spanking his brother and sister with his new nose. When the other elephants could bear it no longer, they all went to the crocodile to get new noses, just like his. So thanks to the very curious elephant child, all the elephants today have long trunk. So my dear students, here the theme of this story is that curiosity can open up new abilities, ideas and knowledge. Even though everyone told him to stop thinking about the crocodile, he kept pursuing his question, and now he has a full grown trunk. So you also have to be curious. Ask many questions to your parents, friends, teachers and your relatives and get your answer from them. Now it's time for the answer of our previous question. I have given you homework. It state true or false. Here you can see first question. I hope you all have done. First question, the elephant child was very curious. It is true. Now the next one, long ago elephants had small noses. It is also true. Now, third question. The elephant's child managed to make his nose smaller by wrapping it in a banana leaf. This is also true. Your answer is true. I request you to repeat your chapter once again at your home. Now, the next question. The baby elephant thought that his new nose was quite useless. It is false. It is false because the baby elephant thought that his new nose was quite useful. Quite useful. Now, fifth one. All the other elephants went to the crocodile to get longer nose. Longer nose. This is false. Now, it's time for your homework. Your homework is answer these questions with reference to the context. Your first question is, go to the grey, green, greasy Limpopo River. She said, you will find your answer there. A. Who said him to whom? B. What answer would the listener find? C. Did he find his answer? So, my dear students, you just try to find your answer from your textbook. In the next video, I will give you the answer of your questions. And once again, I want to remind you that you have to comment in the comment section for your attendance. That is compulsory for you all. So, we are going to stop here. Thank you so much. God bless you.